Hi, Mark Werwey here in beautiful West Abbotsford. I'm the Member of Parliament for Langley Aldergrove and really excited to be at Campbell's Gold. This is the honey farm and meadery, and I'm with Jenny Campbell and very excited to be here and find out about honeybees and what's happening here in this part of the world. It's springtime and you're going to be able to provide some samples here on honey. And when I get these packages of honey, go out for coffee and get these little packages, and I treat that honey like gold, because to make one of those packages of honey, it's a lot of bees that have done a lot of work to get that honey to us. So a little drop of honey, how long, is it one bee that makes just one little drop?
That's right. So for example, a little jar like this, when it's full, would have about 150 grams of honey. So that means it took 150 bees that gave their entire lives to make that jar. So if you were to take just one little dip, why don't we do that? This is our blueberry honey from pollinating our local blueberry farmers in Abbotsford. So one little drop like that, about 6,000 flowers gave up their nectar. One honeybee gave up her life, and about 176 kilometers of flying. Approximately.
Wow, delicious.
It's really good.
And this is local honey here?
It is. This particular honey, we took our bees. So with bees actually navigate with the stars. So they take a picture with their compound eyes as soon as they fly out of the hive. So that way they can look through the atmosphere, they look at the star pattern, and that's how they navigate back and forth. So what you do when you want to get a variety of honey is those older bees fly off, they find a really good selection, and then they say, this is awesome. And they go back to their hive and they teach their sisters by dancing. So they actually navigate with the sun and wiggling, and they make circles. And when you look in the hive, sometimes you can see this bee dancing. It's very subtle. It's like a real agitation. And they'll go in circles and the other bees will follow and they'll cut through, and their wiggling and their movements show exactly where to go to get those flowers. All and then right. They're very, very loyal. So that's how you get something like a blueberry versus a raspberry versus watermelon. These are all local honeys in Abbotsford, or pumpkin or cranberry.
And what are the health benefits? Now, I have some allergies to dust and pollen.
Yeah.
So having honey really helps that, doesn't it?
I don't have allergies, so I don't know if that's because I take honey a lot, but a lot of the people that come into the store actually anecdotally tell me that it really helps, especially if they sometimes include bee pollen. Some people find bee pollen way too strong. They take it and they have an immediate reaction to it. So we always say talk to your doctor before you try that. But honey is not just sugar. It's about 85% sugar, and the rest is enzymes, vitamins, trace minerals, and of course pollen. And so when you're absorbing that small amount, the idea is that your body will slowly build up a resistance to that pollen.
So what do the male honeybees do?
Let's see. They're born and they're just so exhausted, because that was really traumatic, as we know, right?
Yes.
And they have to rest for like 3 weeks, okay? And then they find a whole bunch of other boys and they hang out somewhere in a nice treed area. And then they'll only fly between 12 and 2 and only on nice days, because it's hard work, right? And they have huge eyes and they're more in the back of their head than a worker bee. And that's because their only job in life is to look for a queen bee that has not been mated. And she flies at about 250 feet in the air, and they're gonna just fly under there, and they're gonna find a queen bee, and they're gonna try and see what they can do.
So all the honey that we have here is all the females.
It's all made by worker bees, and worker bees are genetically identical to their queen bee, except they get a different food, and that's why they grow differently.
Well, it's really a treat to be here, and you provide this type of education and incredible quality food here, honey, to people in the community, and people can come. What's your address here?
2595 Lefevre Road, and it's right on Abbotsford Aldergrove border.
And a beautiful red barn.
It
you
is.
You can see it from the road, and you provide tours?
We do. We do seniors tours for free, because we love to give back to our community. We also do tons of children's tours and school tours. We'll also do a tour for any group of five. You just have to book ahead with us. We love to teach people about bees. It's a huge part of what we do here, because as you know, they're struggling.
Well, and I'm a senior, so I get to be here for free.
See?
And you're online?
We are. We have Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, and you just have to Google Campbell's Gold Honey Farm and Meadery, and that's Meadery with a D. We don't sell any kind of meat products here, and we'd love to hear from you.
So Jenny, tell me about the mead.
Oh.
So mead is, that's a type of wine.
It is. So it's actually thought to be the oldest kind of wine known to man. So they found residue from 3,000-year-old pots in ancient Sumeria. And also the Vikings probably were the ones that made it most famous. Some people think it's more of an ale, but that all depends on the kind of yeast that you use. So we make a wine style. We do one that tastes like nectar. So if you can imagine an alcoholic flower that you can put a straw in and you get the smell and then you get the sip of that dewy nectar, we make a mead like that. And then we also make a mead that's very, very dry and has notes of cocoa and you taste a toasted kind of flavor to that. So those are the meads that we do. And then we do a whole range of wines that we make from fruit and honey. 80% of that fruit is right from this farm, including about 4 acres of Riesling grapes in the backyard.
Well, you have a beautiful farm and a beautiful meadery and honey store. And so I encourage you to come to see Campbell's Gold right here in West Abbotsford on Fever Road, and you'll be as thrilled as I am. So please make that a must-go this summer.
Thank you.